Do you ever question why you are not closing as many people as you'd like in your business? Or perhaps you're wondering what questions to ask your leads during the closing phase? So in this episode number 108, I'm going to share with you some tips to know and have a better idea of where you are in the process with your prospects so you both know what direction to take. So stay tuned. Hey, Thierry here from thierryvalexander.com. I help makeup artists, network marketers, and entrepreneurs create an effective presence online so you can attract all the best qualified leads to your business and monetize your brand much faster, easier, and while having fun along the way. If you're new here, consider subscribing because each and every week I do create a new episode, and also I'm attaching to it a PDF cheat sheet, a guide of some sort that is there to empower you in your business and also in your lifestyle. In this episode number 108, I'm going to share some tips and ideas to know where you're at in the process of closing with your prospects so you both know what direction to take at the end of your presentation. Closing sounds like a big word, just like selling does. However, the funny part is that we do it naturally each and every single day as human beings. Wherever there are a minimum of two people involved in a conversation where one is asking a question to the other one, there's most of the time a negotiation which is involved. For example, if a child is asking their parents to go to a friend's party, then the child is going to give all the arguments in the world to convince the parents to go to that party. He is trying to sell and is selling the party and trying to close the deal for the parents to accept it. However, it doesn't have to be complicated, even though it is best to have a structure so you know how to proceed. My first tip to have a higher ratio of people saying yes to you and at least closing effectively is to be strategic. In my many years of entrepreneurship, I've realized the importance of setting up the follow-up date and time for people to give you a feedback of what they've absorbed from the resources you've given them. This is a way to make your prospect commit to circling back and interact and give you some answers and perhaps some questions to what you've shared with them as information. That way you both know where you stand as well in the process. And yes, I agree with you that it might feel a little bit weird to ask for a follow-up date and time before giving the information you're about to share with them. Yet it will actually position you as a professional in what you're doing and make sure that you are also having control over the process of following up and having the information that you need back. I usually say something like, after watching the information I'm about to share with you, you're going to have some great questions and I want to make sure to give you the answers you need. This video is about 10 minutes long. When do you think you could watch it by? Very nice, concise, direct, and showing people that you're willing to give them the resources, but when are they willing to commit to circle back and give you their feedback? And as you know, each and every single week I bring you a PDF, a guide, a cheat sheet of some sort to help you empower you in your own way within your business. This week, because we're talking about effective closing, positioning you basically as a leader, as an authority, as a true business entrepreneur, I'm giving you access to my 7 steps to success guide, which is going to help you create success before even succeeding. So if you want to get access to this guide, just click the yellow button below this video and that will be sent immediately to your email box. If you're on my YouTube channel or any other platform, just check the description section around this video somewhere. That will give you a link taking you back to my blog. And again, once you're there below this video, you'll see a massive yellow button that you cannot miss. Once you click it, you'll get access to my 7 steps to success guide. My second tip to close effectively is to be reliable. You see, so many people tend to lack in that area, which I used to do for many, many years. And this is to show up when you said you would. Of course, it can happen to have a sudden event making us unable to turn up because we're only human after all. Yet it is really important to build the trust factor in your people's minds. And that is created when you are being reliable, showing up when you said you would, or at the very least, letting them know early enough, as early as you can, that you're not going to be able to make the event. And my final tip, far from being the least, really important actually, is that you've got to ask. This is another huge part where I used to mess up completely. Even when I was good at showing up to the follow-up meeting and that I was creating that credibility around that area, I was always forgetting to ask the question, the real important question, and instead make the meeting turn into a friendly catch-up. So the meeting would go something like, oh, so what? Did you like what you've heard and what you've seen? Oh, okay, cool. Do you want another cup of tea? And that was it. The meeting was off. Look, if you're in business, you've got to be comfortable asking for the question in order to help people guide them in the right direction. And for the sake of having an answer as well, you are putting time, money, and energy, or so should you, so move fast in the process. Remember that success loves speed. You might have heard that before, but it is so true. When you're creating momentum, this is going to go much faster, and people love joining what is moving fast. Here are the three non-negotiable questions that I ask when in a follow-up meeting and the closing phase. First one is, what did you like about what you've heard and seen? Not did you like it, but what did you like about what you've heard and seen? That is an open question that is going to make them think and give you some content. The second question is, do you see an opportunity for yourself within what you've seen and heard, or do you see a benefit of using that product that you've learned about? And the final question is there anything else that you'd like to know before we get you started? Or is there anything else that you'd like to know before we get your order through? It really comes down to those three simple yet effective questions, which are going to frame the direction you're going to take with your prospects next. Of course, there might be some other questions in the process, in between, etc. But these three questions are the ones to keep in mind, so it keeps you on track with where you've got to go within your follow-up meeting. In conclusion, people love following those who are reliable and know where they are going. So be that person that people want to follow for those reasons. And remember, I've got your back as well with my 7 Steps to Success guide. If you want to get access to it, just click below this video on the yellow button, and that will be sent automatically to your email box. Did you get value out of this video training? I truly hope that you did. If you did, of course, you know what to do. Share it with your fellow network marketers, makeup artists, entrepreneurs, whomever you believe could get benefit from knowing how to close more effectively, or who wants to increase the ratio of people saying yes to what they've got going on. Question of the week: what is the biggest challenge that you're stumbling across in the follow-up process? Share with me in the comment section. I'd love to help you if there's anything I can do at all. Thank you so much for tuning in. I love connecting with you each and every single week. This video training is a wrap, but I will see you on the next episode. Bye bye bye.